Let's explore how to use pinned position on EditorX. Pinned position lets you lock elements to the position of their parent containers. This means that when an element is pinned, it will stay in place as you scroll through the content in its parent. Let's dive into how it works. In this example, we've added two elements, a shop button and a new collection image, and both are set to the default position type. To pin an element, set the position type to pinned from the dropdown and select which parent you want to pin it to. If we pin the shop button to the page, it will stay visible as the user scrolls through the site's sections. And, for example, if we want the element to appear in the bottom right corner, we can dock this element to the right and the bottom and add margins to distance the element from the page's borders. When we switch to preview mode, you can see that the shop button now stays in place as you scroll the page. You may be familiar with this pin-to-page behavior as the CSS attribute fixed. Now let's see what happens when we pin an element to its parent container. First, let's return to edit mode. Here we have a layouter set up as a slider where the scroll is horizontal. To get the behavior we want, we'll click on the element and choose pinned position again from the inspector panel. You can see we have a few options under the pin to dropdown. Pin to page, which we just used, pin to section, which would cause an element to stay in place until we reach the next section, and pin to layouter, which in this case is our container. We'll choose pin to layouter. And to set the distance between the pinned element and the layouter content, we can add margins. Also, if we drag the element across the canvas, it will stay relative to its parent container and won't attach to any other containers. You can choose to place the element outside of the parent container, but for this example, we'll keep the element inside the parent container we pinned it to. If we click preview, we can see that the element is now locked in place. It's worth noting that once pinned position is set up, it will automatically be applied to all breakpoints. Changes to your pinned position settings will also affect other breakpoints, including removing or changing the element's parent. As an example, notice how changing the element's position type back to default on mobile also affects its position on desktop. If you don't want an element to be pinned at a lower breakpoint, right-click the element and select Don't Display, or go to the Layers panel, select the element and click Don't Display. You can also add an element to replace it. However, when we hide the element on mobile, this doesn't affect the desktop layout. The element is still displayed at this breakpoint. EditorX is an advanced creation platform. To master it, continue watching this series of video tutorials.